Do you doubt that Christ can save that person? Do you know it seems so hard and bitter? Have you ever said, he'll never get saved? Where do people say that? He'll never get saved. But the girl there says, she's too far gone now for God to rescue. You never get too far for God to rescue.
Man.
See, cooperation. These four men work together. There was no way one guy could carry the man. Two wouldn't work either. But he had four corners. He still had to do it. But four were just perfect. Each one of them had a corner. They had to be going the same direction, traveling the same speed. Have y'all ever been an undertaker before? Pallbearer before? Y'all have, any. I had these penny loafer shoes on for the chuck. And we had to carry that body. God, this seemed like forever. Uphill. And this guy stepped on my foot. Here I was, walking by. So, these guys had to be in order, didn't they? They had to be in sync. Had to do a lot of coordinating. We should be people, helping people find people. We should be people, helping people finding people. They need Jesus. Togetherness is always better. Amen?
Man.
There's no strife in a church. The church is always stronger. You gotta have unity. We've got it. We don't need to form a committee to cooperate with others for bringing people to Jesus. Baptist is the worst committee. We got all kinds of committees and they never only been on, only just been on one. I don't even know why we had it. There's a guy named James Vernon McGee, or J. Vernon McGee, a renounced evangelist, once said, committees are made of those who take down minutes, waste hours, and yet the committee is made up of a group of people who individually can do nothing, but together they can decide that nothing can be done. Number seven is costly. It will almost cost you something to bring someone to Jesus. If everyone would be doing that, might cost us financially, whatever it takes. Sometimes the person may be hungry. If you're hungry, sometimes you need to meet that physical need before you meet the spiritual need.
Amen.
That stomach goes growling, then I'm going to talk this to you. Certainly cost you time and energy. It may cause you to miss your favorite TV show. They call you to miss the Super Bowl. Andy, I'm down on that Super Bowl night.
Hey, we got the score.
It wasn't easy to carry this guy to Jesus. Plus, they may have to pay for the roof. But they tore a hole in them. Maybe have a friend today struggling in a relationship. Maybe it's a health issue or depressed. Stressed out, addiction. Let's go to Jesus with that need because he cares for him so much. Again, let's pray like we've never prayed before for the next 2 weeks. God will send a revival. But first, in our lives, in our hearts. And then see what happens.
Man.
Then see what happens. Amen. I hope you've started on it already. Hope you've been praying for all the services. Amen. Not just revival. You remember several years ago, we'd come here, knew something was going to happen. We just knew it. We'd do something and walk out. But you know what? That's all a lot of them done is walked out. You haven't seen them since. Something wrong. If you're going to want to go to church somewhere,
man,
you may be mad at the preacher, you may be mad at the deacon, but there's not a church in town that's full.
That's right.
If people use that excuse, I don't like Brother Ronnie. I said this morning, you ain't got to like me, but you got to love me. But if we had the love of Jesus, where would we be? There's a song that Brian Free sings, and I'm close. Where would you be 25 minutes ago if Jesus came by?
Man.
Where would you be? As we stand.